Hi, guys. Oh, league night at Coda. And about to go qualify. Sorry, it's, you know, it's August in Tucson, which means it's really hot. So I have the fan set up in addition to the AC running. And I'm trying to figure out the whole microphone thing. So I'm hoping this is going to be good enough placement on my microphone so that I don't get a bunch of wind blowing from that thing. Because we're in that stretch where it's 105 to 110 every day. And that's tough for the AC to keep up with when the PC is running in here. I'm racing. See how it goes. Practicing again. In that case, I'll do a few more laps. Practice race last night was my first race here at Coda. And I think it went okay. I think I learned some things. Where are you going, guys? I think they reset the practice thing because the ACC servers went down something like 5 or 10 minutes before we were supposed to begin joining. So we have to do it as a LAN server, and especially when you have some newer people, that can be a little bit complicated getting things going. better.
Yellow flag, yellow flag, be careful.
Simons ran a 205.4 in the Fiat for silver division. That's really damn good. A 205.5 was my PB from this past week of prepping for this race. So I wouldn't say that I'm, you know, pissed off about my time. It's, you know, it's 0.4 off of my PB. But this is the first time I'm at this track. So, you know, in a way you've got to expect a little lack of confidence, you know. So I'm not overly shocked that I'm that far off, and should be pretty much a full second off of. So that's gonna wind up putting me quite a ways back in the field. It looks like 17. Gold drivers, which means if I'm lucky I'll be around P22, and I think 25 is more likely. Regardless, I kind of think that this is going to be, starting from the back like that, almost certain my race pace is solid. So I think the key, first of all, will be to come out of sector one in particular and lap one fairly clean, probably pit. That, my best guess, that's going to be my best strategy. And check my math real quick. Should have going 94 plus one, and that should be a couple of liters too much. There's a good chance it'll be a full lap or so too much. Just depends on how quickly the leaders can cross the line for the last lap, because I'm expecting it's going to be either 28 or 29 laps. Include the pit stop. So I'm putting in enough for 29 laps, but won't be shocked if it will. Diego, I think during the week managed something like a 204.7 in the Ferrari, was the best time we saw in the Fiat. The biggest thing for this race for me is just to try to collect points, since it's a new track to me. I knew I wasn't going to be overly competitive. So the goal is really just to avoid the drive-through and collect whatever points I can before we move on to next week. Try to stay in the hunt, you know, for Silver Division. Try not to kick myself out of it. There's Griff with a 205 flat. And Diego comes in with a 204.9. Mia, 204.7. Now we're starting to see the times. Get it, Diego? Yep, he got it. See what Mia's got to follow him up. Nope. Don't think anybody's gonna get to. That's good quality by the top three. I mean, look how quickly the times drop. You know, 6 tenths from P4, 8 tenths and above. once you get to Simons. So, hey, P25, unless Brandon punks me and pushes me back a little bit. Patrick's not, so. Damn it. I almost hope Brandon does punk me, because I'd rather start on the outside. But he's not going to. Came up just short. I started on the inside last night in the practice race, and honestly, that sucked. I mean, you just get jammed up so badly there on the inside, while the outside lane is able to maintain some space and some speed and just go around you. It's like Mert and I started next to each other last night, me on the inside, him on the outside, and I dropped 6 spots and he picked up 6 spots. So. Okay, 1 liter. Everything looks good. Shot of nasal spray to try and keep my allergies at bay during this race. Fingers crossed. For lots of things.
So
Yeah, that was stupid. Rooker, not sure what you were doing there, man. I think I picked up a spot or two on that pit stop. I was just in and out a little bit quicker. That was kind of a bullshit one. Spangler, I think it was Spangler, coming out of the pits right there was not something I knew how to handle on this track, because case of first impression, you know what I mean? Just don't know situations and braking points well enough, that kind of thing. And to be distracted on both sides, that was a perfect example of welcome to a new track. Times are way too slow now. Come on, guys, pick it up. better on the brakes than Nick is. But I haven't been able to get close enough to make use of it in one of the heavy braking zones. Gotta start making him think. Thank you. That was a little harsh. Come on, give me a slipstream. Don't just drive away from me. Jeffrey with the first drive-thru. Okay, Mert. Comic Racing versus Comic Racing. Thank you. Jeff must have gotten into the back of Wheeler there. The fuck did Patrick get in front of me? Can I outdrag an Audi? I don't think so. He must have served a drive-thru. Okay, man. Pull your head out of your ass. Never gonna catch Merc that way. Are my brakes going? I don't think my brakes are going. I think I'm just getting a little bit tired and kind of uncertain what the car is doing.
Thank you.
Eddie Daniel picked up 130 seconds. Okay, that's going to be interesting. I wonder if that's a failure to recognize a pit stop. That may or may not have been good, so that could be either... That could be a position for me or not, depending on whether or not he has a valid complaint. And... Yeah, because it moved him all the way back to 30th. So... I guess we'll see what happens with that. If he made a valid pit stop that wasn't recognized, you know, then the stewards may clear that and reinstate him at his previous position. So either P18 or P19 for me. Honestly, I don't think I could complain too much about that race. Obviously, the traffic was a pain in the ass. And I think what really screwed me up was when Spangler came out of the pits. Because that's really what cost me the time. That cost me two positions that I then had to go and get back, and it just took forever. But you know, growing pains. It's kind of the sort of thing that you would expect from a track that you've never really been to. So, no drive-through, you know, no incidents, and some good fights. You know, not necessarily people I wanted to be behind, but they were good fights. Let's see. So, nice job, Mia, on the win, and Diego and Jeremy on the podium. Let's see. Travis and Griff with top 10s. Merck right in front of me. So, overall, not a bad night for Comic Racing. Danny, 23. Let's see. Who else am I missing? I'm missing someone else. Oh, Comer. Comer right behind Griff. So actually, three in the top 10 for Comic Racing. Nice job, gents. Let's see. What do I want to see? I do want to... I think the one thing I want to take a look at is when I was... When I was attacking... When I was attacking Nick, because I'd said I needed to put some pressure on him, and I was trying to really hard in the braking zones where I had the advantage, just to try to make him think and do something else. Yeah, there it is. I don't remember where I got by him, so okay. So I think I'll start here, because I think that around here is where I started really trying to pressure him. Sure that I didn't stick it in there on him too hard at any point. I don't think I did, but I want to double check that. Thank you. That was okay. That was good hard racing by both of us. I'd gotten out in front of him right here, and he was going to try to, you know, he at this point, he didn't have the corner. You know, I was far enough out in front of him that he didn't. And he was trying to kind of scare me into leaving him more room. But me cutting him off right there was, I would say, fairly aggressive. Want to see from overhead. See where he got to before turning. Because see, he's far enough back that he doesn't have a right to the corner at this point. And he doesn't get anywhere near until after turning. So at this point, it's too late to stick your nose in there with any right to the corner, right? That is the rule. So I was entitled to take the apex at this point, and he was right to back off. I mean, it was a good try on his part, but he handled it correct under the circumstances. So yeah, good fight there, and good fighting up and down the board, really. So I think that's it. We go to Donington next week. Let's see. So yeah, Donington next week. So that's it for tonight. Not a bad race. I collected some points, and I'm still okay, I think. So. That's it. Have a good night, everybody. Take care. We'll see you later. Bye.